What is going on, guys? DBG here. In this video, we are going to be doing a gameplay with the Pink Diamond Kawhi Leonard. The Pink Diamond Dr. J gameplay did not go the best because, well, as I explained in the video, after a week of basically 3 hours of sleep, I started off incredibly well. After a week of about 3 hours of sleep, I conked out in the middle of the game. I genuinely fell asleep in the middle of the game, and he ended up only with like 31 points. But this Dr. J card is incredible. Regardless of how much he put up, he ended up with like 14 in the first quarter playing his full Pink Diamonds. He's incredible. Kawhi Leonard is almost as good stats-wise. He was a 17 Hall of Fame badge, one-man fast break chasing, and his pickpocket, pick dodger, defensive stopper, picking around master, relentless finisher, acrobat, posterizer, lob city finisher, corner specialist, mid-range Jedi, deep range Jedi, limitless range, difficult shots, tireless score, catch and shoot, as well as 8 goal badges. He's also got some of the best stats in the game. He's at 98 driving layup, a 97 post fade, 92 post hook, nothing under 85. He's got 98 shot mid, 98 shot 3 with nice release. He's got limitless as well, so that's going to feel even better. 92 ball control, he's got really nice rebounding stats as well for small forward. 99 lateral quickness, he's got 99 steal, 99 on ball defensive IQ as well. 98 driving dunk with a 100 tendency. 97 speed, 97 acceleration, 94 speed with balls, really nice. 98 vertical, 96 strength, 98 stamina. This card is going to be absolutely incredible. So this is the team we are running with. We've got Ben Simmons at the 1, Kawhi at the 2, Julius Erving at the 3, Dr. J at the 4, Anthony Davis at the 4, and Kareem at the 5. The bench, we have got Giannis at the 1, Paul George at the 2, LeBron at the 3, KD at the 4, and Hakeem at the 5, Kobe Bryant, Tim Duncan, and Tracy McGrady rounding out the bench. So anyway, yeah, now let's get on to the hot zones for Kawhi, then we're going to get on to the game. Okay, so just like Dr. J, Kawhi's got hot zones everywhere on the floor. Kawhi has got limitless as well, and his release is cash in my opinion, especially out the catch. I don't know how he'll do. Like, I didn't do too well with the diamond when I used his diamond as like a main option as a scorer, but his diamond was incredible because I had the pink diamond shoe on him just as like a 3-and-D guy. He was the best 3-and-D guy in the game, and he kept the spot on my team, and well, basically until this card came out. But yeah, Kawhi is going to be an absolutely incredible card, one of the best shooters in the game, regardless of position. He's got some insane shooting stats. He can dunk really well with the best defensive wing in the game by far. And this Kawhi is going to be insane. Like, I cannot believe they released a Kawhi that's better than the best LeBron, which is nuts. Like, it's actually better than the best LeBron, Kawhi Leonard. And it's better than the best Michael Jordan as well. So if you're judging by 2K, Kawhi Leonard is the second greatest player of all time, according to 2K cards anyway. But he's greening all these. Now let's just green one, limitless three. And now let's get on to the game. All right, so Kobe, Kawhi Leonard, LeBron, Giannis, and Embiid. This team is really nice. Not as good as my team, but it's a really nice team. And this guy is in the Pink Diamond League. Of course, like, if you're on PC, 95% of the Pink Diamond League players are guys that will quit out against a good team and just be terrible teams. So I can't expect anything different. All right, so that's who we're playing. Okay, we are not playing a good squad at all. We're playing against a guy with Ruby Michael Red. Ruby Michael Red, a card that I'm not sure I've ever come up against in this game. Okay, Patrick Beverley is now guarding Kawhi Leonard. Nearly pushed him into the backcourt, which is crazy. Wait a minute, he's got Ruby Patrick Beverley. That card's 400k. You could sell him and buy an entire Pink Diamond squad. Like, it's 400k on PC because it's so rare. But like, that card itself is worth an entire Pink Diamond squad in this game. Why the hell does he have a ruby that's worth 400k in his team without anything better than a ruby? Go Kawhi to the basket, and Kawhi Leonard finishes the layup. See, who did I have playing center? I didn't even see. Or power forward. That doesn't even matter anyway. We're just going to destroy them. To be fair, we should be all right. But the fact is that his... do you know that Patrick Beverley is more expensive than both Pink Diamond, Dr. J and Pink Diamond Kawhi on PC. And he's got him. I'm just in shock. Good job, Kawhi, backcourt. Great defense, lads. We gotta start scoring. Like, we've put up 2 points, and it's been 2 minutes. Burn them, pull up from mid. And Kawhi knocks it down, let's go. Hey, we got him with the blow by. And Kawhi with the easy dunk. All right, Kawhi with 6 in the first quarter. Not a great first quarter. Not a great first quarter by any of the teams, to be honest, but hopefully he picks it up. Alright, let's see if we can build up a bit of a lead with the bench. Like, this guy's actually good at the game. Like, his team is bad, but him himself, he's good. Like, I'd say even teams, he's probably better than me. Kawhi, one more to LeBron for 3. Green light. We can take the lead. Alright, 5 seconds to go. Okay, fade away. I think he has difficult shots. Yep, I'm fairly sure he does if he hit that shot. And we got a 4-point lead. From really deep, Paul George. All right, 4-point lead at the end of the first. Terrible start to the game. Let's get Kawhi Leonard back in to start the second because I think we can go on a little bit of a run now and we can pull this away. The defense, AD. Hey, we're actually playing great defense. We're just not scoring at all. Kawhi steps into the three and Kawhi can't hit it. I get it again, open for three. Finally, let's go. Oh, pull up. Three. There we go, Kawhi Leonard. All right, now he's starting to get into it a little bit. 10-point lead. Why not pull up the floater instead? To be fair, I've started putting floaters on fast breaks because you get fouled a lot more often behind on floaters. Because you slow down a little bit and it lets the other team, sometimes they might stop and not try to block it. And a lot of times they end up fouling you with that. Am I the only one that's noticed that? Like, that's just something I've been doing the last couple of days and it's been working really well for me, putting floaters on breaks. This guy really is not bad. He's done a lot of really good things. It's just he doesn't have the players to really use against me, which he'll get if he sells that Beverly, as I've said about 10 times in this video. I just cannot believe that he's got a card that expensive in a squad this bad. Good shot, Hakeem Olajuwon. Let's get leads now 12. Like, you can see that he's good at the game. He just doesn't have the players to utilize what he's trying to do. LeBron for three, and LeBron knocks it down. All right, it's a two, damn. At least a 14-point game, so we should be, well, we should definitely win anyway. Deep, let's go Paul George. Finally, he hits a limitless three. He gives us a 17-point halftime lead. Okay, let's attack. Kawhi Leonard to the basket, and Kawhi with the crazy layup there and draws the foul. I'm guessing free throw is somewhere in the high 90s, but like it has to be at least 90. I think he only has like three stats under 90. But yeah, like he probably is gonna end up scoring a lot more than Dr. J, but like if you're looking for a guy to take over a game, I would 100% recommend Dr. J over Kawhi. But if you're looking for like a glue guy, I'd recommend Kawhi over absolutely anybody in this game. There is not one player I'd recommend as a glue guy over Kawhi Leonard. From deep, green light, let's go. Leads now 20, double scores. All right, safe to say we're comfortable and we've won this game. Kawhi now with 21 points. He's starting to play his way into the game though. He's definitely better than he was in the first quarter. He scored six. Catch on the break. Kawhi Leonard, easy layup. Let's go. Got him with whatever the hell that was. Fake. Okay, if Kawhi Leonard somehow scores a basket in this possession, it would be mad. And he somehow comes out with an and one in that possession. I don't know how. He got like three offensive boards, pulled out some crazy moves, but comes out in that possession with 3 points and probably three missed field goals. Three, Kobe. Green light. Like a 3-2 zone is not great this year. Like the 3-2 zone was effective in 2K17. It was effective in 2K16. It's not effective at all this year. Wide open for three, Kawhi. Kawhi knocks it down. All right, this is nearly a 40-point game. Like, well, it started off very, very tight. We just blew him out in the end. I just spotted her in 2-3 zone, so I know what offense to go into. 2-3 zone offense. Kawhi Leonard wide open right there. And he knocks it down. We'll be able to get three every single time in this offense. Steal Kawhi all the way to the basket. Easy dunk. And he's going to come up with more than 40. Does not mean he's better than Dr. J who dropped 30. Well, at scoring. Probably is a better card in general. But, yeah, at least he's put up a solid scoreline in this game. Wide open, Kawhi Leonard. Or semi-contested. He still knocks it down anyway. He's got them shooting badges. Let's go. You can't zone me up with a team like this unless you're like a YBC and you're great with the off-ball zone. And even YBC would struggle against me with a team like this in that zone. Okay, fadeaway three from deep. All right, he can't hit that. I don't think he's got Hall of Fame difficult shots, which he definitely needs for that shot there. Kawhi ends up with 41 points in a win by nearly 50 there. So Kawhi Leonard shot less than 50% from the field, less than 50% from three. However, in the second half, he shot over 50% from both of them, if that's any consolation. His first quarter, 3 of 9, the second quarter, 3 of 8, were both absolutely terrible. But he had a solid enough second half. Kawhi Leonard also did get 2 steals, which was nice, and he's an unbelievable defender, but just didn't have the best game offense-wise, even though he did put up 41 points. If I had a shot better and played better with him, I could have put up close to 60, I'd say. So anyway, that's the video. Would I recommend this Kawhi Leonard for you guys to purchase if you're looking for a guy to win you games by himself? No. Would I recommend this Kawhi Leonard to purchase if you've got a squad like this and you need a guy who's the best defender in the game, one of the best shooters in the game, and can do absolutely everything well and be the single best glue guy in the game? Yes. Kawhi Leonard is the ultimate glue guy, the single best role player you can pick up in my team just to kind of be on the squad. Because a lot of guys, like, for example, Paul George is another guy who can be used as a role player really well. For example, if you just want LeBron as a spot-up shooter and playing defense, he's not going to be used correctly and he's going to struggle like that. Whereas you can use Paul George or Kawhi like that. Kawhi Leonard will have a spot in my team probably for the rest of the year, along with the Paul George. Just the two of those cards. Like, of all of these cards, even over Giannis and LeBron, I'd say Kawhi Leonard's spot is safer in this team. So anyway, yeah, it's a really nice card. While obviously putting up points isn't his biggest strength, he still did that relatively well towards the end of the game. But he's an unbelievable shooter, unbelievable defender, and a great card. So anyway, that's the video. Thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe.